got is I got a drawing of the nose casting, which goes in the front upper part of the cowling, just in back of the propeller spinner. And it made a pattern of what our actual shape is of that casting, and we're gonna it doesn't quite fit what we made, but it's close. And John made that pattern. What we're gonna do is we've taken that and then bring my hand that one down.
Sorry, Art.
That's okay. Have a good catch.
Hey, we're
on film. So to speak. Okay. So what I've done is I've folded that down the center line because our accuracy is not perfect by a long shot. And what we're doing now is making this, I kind of average this curve, both bottom and top. And then, where's my aluminum piece? Up there. And we're cutting the same thing out of a quarter inch thick piece of aluminum, which will be the start of this simulated front nose casting. We're just in the process of cutting this lower curve. And what we intend to do then is to force this into that shape. This isn't going to move it. The aluminum's going to move a little bit, so we're going to force it kind of into symmetry. And then add thickness to this in one or two layers of a heavier aluminum, which is, oh, I got that over the bench, but that'll be 3/4 inch. So the total of this is going to be this, which is quarter, and 2 3/4, which will be an inch and a half, inch and 3/4 thick. And that'll look from the front end view, this will have out the air intake hole carved out of it. From the side, it'll look just like the casting. We've done this in several places on the airplane where the original parts were either forged aluminum or cast aluminum, and we've fabricated them out of sheet stock or plate stock. Where the another homemade device here. This is just a gauge, really. And this is to simulate where the propeller spinner would overlap a fixed piece on the airplane. So that's not where the propeller spinner is moving with the propeller blades. That's this dimension right here is what the overlap is, what the dimension is on this step. You can hold this jab right here so that this edge right here is right in this exact dimension. Now, if you turn it, yeah, you got to turn it sideways.
Oh, okay.
Now you turn it like that, and that's how far back it goes. In other words, this is the propeller spinner overlaps this piece, comes back to here. So that's all kind of in the eyeball or side view of what it's supposed to be. Now the thing I'd like to do, in addition to checking this, is get a good, on the microfiche, get a good side view of the fuselage in that area. Because all I've got really is that little picture Captain Vance spoke to show that 10.5 crease.
Right.
And we'll pull that joint angle out. And I think we could get a pretty accurate looking thing from that initial view.
That's it.